Hi everyone. Today I'll give a short demo on how to fix a common floor contact issue for your animated character. I'll be using this animated robot from my last tutorial as an example. In that tutorial, I talked about animation in USD and gave a preview of the AI animation tool Wonder Studio. If you haven't watched it yet, I've included the link in the description. Now, without further ado, let's dive right in. Here we see the left foot of the robot is below ground, which needs to be corrected. We can use the HumanIK tool in Maya to create a control rig for fixing it. The HumanIK tool is located on the side panel to the right. First, I'll go to shading and turn on the X-ray joints so that I can see the skeleton. Then in HumanIK, click Create Character Definition. This creates a HumanIK skeleton definition. We see the figure here with different body parts. And this is for mapping out the structure of our character's skeleton so that the HumanIK solver can understand it. To map a part here to the corresponding part in the robot's skeleton, double-click on a part, and then single-click the corresponding joint in the outliner. For example, if I double-click on the hips, and then click the hips in the outliner, it maps the hips of the robot to the hips of the HumanIK figure. Similarly, I'll map out the other parts of the body. For parts like the spine, which contains subcomponents, we can access the subcomponents by clicking the arrow next to it. For example, here I can map spine 1 and spine 2, and click this arrow to go back to the full body view. I'll fast forward a little bit for the mapping of the remaining parts. Once we've mapped all the parts, we can create the control rig by clicking this icon. Now we have the control rig. One more thing we need to do before making adjustments is to bake the skeleton into the control rig. To do that, change the source to none. Click the blue icon and select Bake, Bake to Control Rig. Now we see the skeleton with the control rig. With the control rig, you can easily make different kinds of adjustments. For example, if you need to invert a knee or elbow, go to Definition, click the blue icon, and select Edit Character Definition. Under Invertible Joints, you can choose which one you want to invert. For this robot, I don't need to invert any joint, so I'll keep them unchecked. The left foot is what we want to adjust, so I'll click the left ankle here. To adjust its position or rotation, we can use the Graph Editor. Go to Windows, under Animation Editors, select Graph Editor. To fix the position, I'll select Translate Y. Here we see the frames where the foot is below ground. I'll select this part and use the Region tool to move and scale it. Now we see the foot is above ground. You can also do some fine-tuning for the foot to touch the ground when it should. If I switch to the front view, you'll see more clearly that the foot position has been fixed. In addition to the position, you can also adjust the rotation. To demo that, I'll select Rotate Y and use the Smear tool to make the curve smoother. You can middle mouse and drag left to right to change the size of the tool. When you finish editing, you have the option to bake the control rig animation back to the skeleton. That's how you can fix the floor contact issue. Let me know in the comment if you have any questions. Thanks for watching, stay tuned, and I'll see you next time.